He is like that. As a head of the department, he never sits like this. He sits in a corner like this only, as if this is somebody's seat. I am using it for some time. That's the way he behaves. A beautiful teacher. He starts from that corner. After 2 hours, he will end. Our board was full. What? He starts there. His class will end only there. And after that, he will make it into pages and say, "This is first page, second page, third page, fourth page, fifth page, sixth page." And that, if you can, we didn't have a smartphone those days. Otherwise, you could have taken a clip. That would have been our notebook. He writes neat. Fantastic teacher. So I was going to him first day to his room to say that I am right. He said, "I am coming to class. You be there." He understood what for I am coming. He said, "I will come there. Be there." I didn't have patience, but then he was. We could not shout at him. That's his face. So I went and sat there. But then I don't want to allow him to teach without clarifying my doubts. That was my state of mind. Immediately he gave the same question paper back to all of us and said, "Justify your answer." What a great example, right? These are our experience. We had a great stalwarts as teachers. I scored very well. Even if I wrote wrong, I justified why I went wrong. Because what I did? I did a homework. What happened to the great scorers who scored 20? They couldn't justify. What did they do? Random, dim, dim, dim. And they didn't spend time. So when you score good marks, you will not do homework. And then he called me and said, "Shashi Kumar, you have gone and then looked at it. This test was not a mathematics test. This was a test to check whether you have real interest in mathematics or not. And I found that you have real interest in mathematics. Otherwise, you would not have justified all these answers. And I am sure yesterday you have done a lot of homework, checking whether you are right or not. If you have just taken it for granted your mark is zero, you will not be able to justify today. Why did you spend time yesterday? You have interest in mathematics. Keep that interest. Stop your IAS. Start coming to classes." Easily. And I stopped my IAS and then came to mathematics. Otherwise, I don't know. I don't become an IAS or not. That's a different matter. I would not have studied mathematics. That was 100% sure. That's why I decided I will study mathematics. That's a great test to test whether you have interest in a subject or not. So sometimes teachers do lot of different tricks in checking the children. It's all part of it. The other day, Reshma came to pick me up in Kayankulam railway station and we were traveling. I said, "Kayankulam, I have a student, Reshma." So we were discussing something. That day, the topic of discussion happened to be "Hum Ho Gaye Kamiyab." Which is that song? That's how we discuss. Sana knows, we take up some random selection of topics and then start discussing. So from railway station to college, our discussion was "Hum Ho Gaye Kamiyab." Then she said, yeah, I know that song." I said, "Who wrote it?" "They do." And I said, "Find out. You will not get an answer that easily. But the English version of it is interesting," I said. "What's the English version?" But then what I did was, I want to confuse her. So I said, "Aisha Rao." You know what happens if you go to Google and find out "I shall overcome"? You will not get it. So she started searching "I shall overcome." Nowhere. Then I said, "Hum ho gaye kamiyab, hum. I shall overcome." I was stressing on this "hum" and "I shall overcome." But she was totally into Google. You remember that we posted on that day. That's the day on 12th. This month 12th. So immediately she got, "Yeah, sir, hum will not become I, it will become we on." I said, "Yeah, that is why I was go on testing you that whether your presence of mind is there or not. What is exactly required for a student is good presence of mind." I was checking. Immediately she came and then said, "My English Malayalam version will be there, you go and search." And we posted there and then said, "My Malayalam version is there," and that, and then we had fun. That's how we learned. So what is most important for a student is good presence of mind. And examination should not be learning what you mugged up and then shown. Because when we select people in most of the departments, either in an MNC company or in a bank or in a research laboratory, whatever PhD I have in mathematics was useless when I applied for a scientist job in space department. Question were very simple, not what we learned in our PhD or MSc or nothing, it's only logic. I remember a pen was kept on a table and then just pushed it like this and given a marker pen and a whiteboard, said that write equation of motion for us. That is my physics test. It is not the equation of motion what we learned in the classroom, but a pen was kept, just somebody just pushed it, the pen moved, write equation of motion was one question. Second question was more logical. We have in Balarama and all that the picture of a tree or two, three trees together like a bush. Identify there are three cats inside this. We take it for granted what we do in our childhood, it's all fun. It's not fun, it's logical reasoning. You need to have good logical reasoning, analytical skill. Identify something which is hidden somewhere is also part of it. Most of our tests, most of the MNC companies, when they test not mathematics. It looks like mathematics, but it is arithmetical reason. It looks like English, it's not English, it's verbal reason. That's why even if you are a PhD in English, they will not be able to answer small English questions because it is not English, it is verbal reason. So it's must. Our children, 85% of the classroom knowledge, unless they are going for a master's or PhD in that subject, is not directly useful for any of the employment. Only 15% is used for their employability skills. So you are getting the best cream. We may not be able to teach them extra physics, extra mathematics, extra chemistry, but educate them to say that these are the extra skills which you require. That is where communication skill, group discussions, verbal ability, logical reasoning. We cannot teach all that under this because WWS is now a program of coaching, not a program of training. It's only a mental. It's much beyond all this to guide them properly where to go and fetch these equations. Where to get what? It's more like a guidance, like a parental guidance. So here we give an emotional touch to our children. One of the students who participated in Calicut is in contact with me, but not for her. Her brother literally failed in plus two. Now some examination is happening. She just left the class without writing. He left without writing examination. So she wanted to come and she is going to meet me on 26th. Not for her, but for her brother. So I said, don't come to me. Just look at my website, learn who is Dr. Shashikumar, then come. Otherwise, I had bad experience of that. Remember, somebody referred from somewhere and somebody comes with the child. Dr. Kanambuwana. So I was in Irinyalakuda. My house is in Irinyalakuda and Kanambuwana. So I was in Irinyalakuda, somebody comes to me. And at home, my costume is generally I have got a. You know, Valsalil cinema? Mammootty. ഒരു വെള്ള ബനിയനും സാധാരണ ഒരു തോർത്തും പറമ്പിലൊക്കെ നല്ലോണം പണിയെടുക്കാറുണ്ട് കൃഷിയൊക്കെ. അതിനിടയിലായിരിക്കും ചിലപ്പോൾ ആരെങ്കിലും. അപ്പോൾ സംബടി കേൾക്കുന്ന ആസ്റ്റ് വാട്ട് കൊടുക്കുക, സർ ഡോക്ടറെ കാണാം. ഡോക്ടർ എവിടെ വെച്ചു? ഞാൻ തന്നെയാണ് ഡോക്ടർ. അപ്പോൾ അവർക്ക് വിശ്വസിക്കാൻ പറ്റില്ല, കാരണം അവർ ഡോക്ടറെ കാണാൻ പോകുന്നവരെ അവരുടെ ധാരണ എന്താ, സ്റ്റുഡൻറ്റിനെ പഠിക്കാൻ കഴിവില്ല, ആകെ ഒരു ഡള്ളായിട്ട് ഇരിക്കുന്ന ഒരു സ്റ്റുഡൻറ്റ് അമ്മയോ അച്ഛനോ ഡോക്ടറെ കാണാൻ കൊണ്ടുപോകുന്ന പറയുമ്പോൾ ആ സ്റ്റുഡൻറ്റിൻ്റെ കൺസെപ്റ്റിൽ ഒരു സൈക്യാട്രിസ്റ്റ് എങ്ങനെ ഇരിക്കേണ്ടാവും ഇല്ലേ, കൺസൾട്ടേഷൻ റൂമിലേക്ക് ഇരിക്കണം. അപ്പൊ എന്നെ കണ്ട ഇതാണ് ഡോക്ടർ. അപ്പൊ ഉടനെ ഡോക്ടർ, സാറ് ഡോക്ടറല്ല വൈദ്യരാണ്. ഞാൻ വൈദ്യരാണ്. ബിക്കോസ് ദ കൺസെപ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് മെന്ററിങ് കംസ് ഫ്രം നോയിങ് ഹൂ ഈസ് യു ആൻഡ് ഹൂ ആർ യു. സോ എസെൻഷ്യൽ ഓൾ ഓഫ് യു ഷുഡ് ഇൻട്രൊഡ്യൂസ് യുവർസെൽഫ് ടു യുവർ മെന്റീസ്. Otherwise, they will, don't think that they will come and open their problem and tell you, sir, I am not able to study anything. Because they are, a chemistry student comes to a English teacher and says, I am not able to study chemistry, what do you say? Yeah, chemistry is a difficult subject. Yeah, I also had same problem. That's why I did not touch chemistry. I started learning English. What will happen to the student? So you should pose your problems. Mentoring is such an activity wherein you must become a magnet and students should come to you. It's essential to show that you have the ability to solve somebody's problems, not to create problems to them. There are a lot of possibilities for changing their life pattern. It's not education alone. It's the whole life. So how do you deal with them? Only when you open up yourself, talk to them. Fine? So look at, somebody may say exam is a big problem, but don't create exam is a big problem and say exam is a big problem, semester is not having time, too much load at syllabus. This should not be our aim. Our aim is to say that all these are casual, good, we are all doing good, we are good, and don't take too much of pain in you so that you will not dump it on somebody else. That's very, very essential. Take everything casual. Much more important is not academics but for life. Life is much more important. So we are all living and our aim is to live happily, learn happily, enjoy learning, enjoy writing exam. That should be the aim. If you want some guidelines on this, you can look at my website. 30 points to students, 20 points to parents and teachers. The title is Enjoy Study and Enjoy Examination. Because I know students don't like exams, but then we do it at college level, school level. Lot of mentoring programs for students are done for appearing examination without fear. That's one thing which I do. So the title of the blog will be Enjoy Study Exams, but you have 30 points to students, 20 points to parents and teachers, which are followed by many students. Many schools are printing it out and then using it in their classrooms. Right? Every student must prepare their own examination and take exam. That's the first thing what they should do. Yesterday I was in Nadu. My house is in Nadu for Talipapa, 20 kilometers far. Just opposite to my house, there is a student who is in 11th grade. She says, March, I was watering the plants, gardening. That time she came and said, sir, March is my exam. I don't know any subject. I am an A plus in many subjects in 10th class. I am from a Malayalam medium, sitting in an English medium class. Nothing I know. I am going to fail in all subjects. That's what she says. I said, go, get a dictionary, get your physics book. Yesterday, I taught her full physics. Only index explained her everything and took only one page and asked her how to learn this. That's what I learned. Main problem is they don't understand any of the English terms. I am sure they may also pass plus one plus two come to you. So one of the best methods for learning disability, learning problems, learning difficulties, learning retardation, learning problems, best method is you must bring them to textbook. They don't have the habit of reading textbook. They don't even have attention in attending classes. I all suggest them to do one thing. Prepare and then go and sit in the classroom. That's what I ask them. Don't go to classroom without reading a text first. Because most of the vocabulary which is used by teachers in the classroom is not known to them. Let it be commerce, economics, physics, chemistry, history, any subject, because the terms, the English itself is not understood by, I'll tell you, 60% of your students. If you want, you can test them. Write down technical terms on a subject which you already taught, ask them to explain, they will fail. This is what happens. They are not able to understand most of the technical terms. I think you must do this. Ask them to refer to dictionary. Understand words inside that. And then we do practices for making them to remember all of them. If this is done, I think they will have a lot of guts to write examination. Because they don't have words in their vocabulary. That's why they cannot write in. These are some of the techniques which we used. Mentoring is not just telling them, don't worry, examination, yeah, you will do well. No. That's not, this is giving extra boost to them saying that everything goes well even if you don't study. So mentors have got a responsibility to give them tricks of learning. How do you learn tricks of learning? There are different methods. You will have to spend a lot of time. You will have to invest a lot of time. You will have to try it out. So that's one of the reasons where WWS is not giving a guide. It's only a guideline. And this cluster workshop is, the frame is given by the new initiative government. I am trying to give you some fresh insight as a training program or a workshop. Or maybe you can take, I am giving you the framework. The flesh is given by the, it's up to you how to take it, right? We had a discussion why it's not becoming very good. Raju Krishna sir and me met in, there is another program called the Flyer. I don't know how many of you are with the Flyer. How many of you, the teachers are with the Flyer? Lift your hands. Nobody here? Do you know what's Flyer? Yes or no?
Yes sir.
You are not part of it. Why? You are not experts in the subjects of your research areas now. In Kottayam when we did, we had 6 teachers who are part of Flyer. One of them went abroad on exchange program. You get fellowship to go to UK and stay there for 1 month or 3 months or something like that to Yamsam University. These are all supported by Higher Education University. Same Raju Krishna sir is also part of that program. So WWS also. And we were discussing that in Maharaja's College, Ernakulam, in one of the program in October. Then as somebody suggested, we don't have training programs in cluster. I said that we will do that. And that's how the whole program was organized. That's how I am going around. Otherwise, earlier clusters program, it's the coordinator's job to find some mentors. And then create a training program in which it's not a full day program, not a single person. Everybody will start sharing, this is my old experience, and then start doing. I thought we should do it from getting suggestions from you. Those who are not in mentoring should give you suggestions because you are not already not into that, so you have a lot of ideas. I'm sure all of us have got some mentors in our life. All of us will listen to somebody, we don't listen to somebody, we know who is good at us and why we should follow him. All that is part of our life. So your experience has to come out. Okay? We never wanted academics to be discussed because you brought in academics examination. I thought I should share you how examination has to look at and why people are scared about examination. And what do I do? You have few children with you, each department at least 1 or 2 children with you. I'm sure if your student becomes the best and if you can train them, they should in turn train their class students because they become torchbearers. So you have a responsibility to light the torchbearers. In turn, the torchbearers will change them. Don't say that it is impossible, it doesn't happen and all. It's all possible, may not be for everybody at every level, but some point, somewhere you'll have to put a start at. I'm sure when Sana said, if she would have just saying that this is my experience, I changed, I would have been not happy. Because we keep telling, whatever knowledge you should have, you should share it. Spread the message which you get to somebody else. Most of the students, when they sit together, they don't discuss their subjects. But I think you made an effort for making your own classmates to discuss. And that's how she could improve, not by herself, but she could also improve her classmates. What we do is, don't make your teachers to give an examination. You make a question paper, give it to your friend, ask them if you can answer it and give it to you. These are few points which I mentioned in the 30 points to students and 20 points to parents and teachers. So examination is not teacher's responsibility, it is student's requirement. We must change it like that. And internal marks need not be from examination, as you have to take a percentage from that and then put it. I remember when I was teaching in Jawaharlal Nehru Technological University in Hyderabad, I never conducted examinations. My internal assessment is done based on my lectures. They are supposed to make a note review and then send it to me back. And that is based on that note, I will give them marks. So that makes my children to be attentive in the class. They will start taking notes. If you want to make a note after your class, what do you do generally? You give notes. Don't give notes in classroom. Ask your children to take notes. A best student is one who takes notes and they make a note and give you back. If they want to make a note, what they have to do? They have to go and refer textbook. Expand on what they have written down. Check whether the spelling is correct or not. check whether they understood it perfectly or not. Force them to read textbooks. That's the first thing what you should do. So this is the technique which I use, and then I propagate among teachers to make the students to take notes and then make notes. I remember I was teaching one of the paper in management in one of the colleges, autonomous college, that used to be only on holidays because that's the program which I love. Emotional quotient for corporate communications. For a BBA, not BBA, it's called BMS, Master of Business, Bachelor of Management Sciences, BMS. It's in Usmania University. All the review notes which my students appeared, it's much more E than this area. Hyderabad, if everybody has got a smartphone, everybody got an internet. So I asked all of them to submit assignments. By that day, same day, evening, before 10 o'clock, they are supposed to send me the notes through email. So I got a lot of material. Everybody was sent. So what I did was, I looked at all the material, selected the best notes, and then made a book. So I have a book on emotional intelligence. I have not written it, it's all contributed by my children. But since I have done the job, it's in my name. And that's a prescribed book in Usmania University under the Autonomous College. It has become a prescribed book. So I think as teachers, you have got lot of ideas. If you have, I think you can create lot of things around. That's a freedom which you have under WWS. You can use your children, and ultimate aim is to make them to dream higher, get them into the spirit of research in their own subjects. Maybe you are a different teacher from a different subject, but make them to be good in whatever subjects they are into. That's it. Fine? Good. So any more inputs? It's only discussions like this. Afternoon we will do something else. Before noon we will have this, because we started with, yeah, few more points. Payyanur College, somebody came, and who else? From the border from Kannur to Calicut, I missed that place again. NMR? Eh? Kallikandi College. Kallikandi College. I heard this earlier also. Next. Who else? SN College, Kannur, somebody came. Who are the, which are the other colleges? Taliparamba Sarsaid College, somebody came. Yeah, you got from Sarsaid. Then. Eh? Nobody came. It's UK? You are from Manjaragan. From other, some other college. Once representatives of some other college come and speak. Come fast. Who came last? Who is the person who spoke last? USL. Identify somebody from some other college. Identify somebody from some other college. That's your task. First. Yeah, she want to come? You are from which college? I met you earlier, right? Yeah, we met earlier. Orientation program. Yeah, come. Pioneer College. No, you could come. Doesn't matter. Yeah, but somebody else from some other college. Come fast. This is the problem with your children. And it's much more in teachers, I think. Come forward. Come forward fast. I don't have this problem in Kottayam. I don't have this problem in Kollam. And no, once we come closer to north, is the problem.
When we started the discussion, I started about the concept of mentoring.
as I get into the discussion with that, and who needs mentoring. And is mentoring something that is to be given forcefully, which becomes somewhat unnatural? Or is it something to be felt by the mentee that he needs guidance, or he needs advice, or he needs some direction in some things with regard to his studies? So college identifies certain students as qualified enough to be mentored, because they have high skills, we think. That's what we thought. But they apply for it, but what do we find in our college is that they don't come to our programs often. As it is discussed here, due to time constraints, due to various other factors. They want to enjoy holidays, they have other business, they have other assignments and all those things. But if it is felt by them that this is going to be beneficial for them, they will definitely come. So we need to change our perspective, that's what is I thought. Because how to bring them into our circle and make them aware that, just kindle in their minds that yes, we are prepared. So we need to arrange short program meant for that. And eventually I think it will be fruitful. That's what I said, sir. So yeah, I've been to our college quite a few programs, and yes, good students there. And I have been to this class and in one of my orientation programs, and it was good. And I take this opportunity to thank you for that. So that's all, sir.
I told you, I had experience of going to colleges where there were only 6 students for a WW schooling. It all depends on you. It's not higher initiative, it's not chief minister, it's not the education minister, it's not the principal, it's not the government, it's the mentors who can play a big role. I think if you motivate your children, I'm sure it will happen. And second one, what I generally don't see when I go for I must have gone to many colleges from Kollam to Kasaragod. Kollam Women's College is one program where I did at WWS, and Kasaragod Government College, I got to Wayanad. Most of the places I went, I visited, except Thiruvananthapuram, I went to all the districts for WWS programs and mentors workshop like this. Many times when we go for WWS, external mentors go, we don't see internal mentors sitting in the class. Especially when it happens to be a Saturday or Sunday or a holiday, no programs are there. I'll tell you, the most relaxing job in the world could be teaching in Kerala. I especially say Kerala because I was in part of JNTU. We conduct examination on Sunday. If one exam is missed because of any reason, either a paper leak or it happens, some malpractice or malfunctioning or any administrative act problems, or maybe sometimes the question tags are sent on internet doesn't work, fail, power failure happens in some portion, maybe there is a bunt. Rarely it stops academic activities in other state other than Kerala. Hyderabad, I never had a single day holiday in 20 years of my service because of bunt. Every day I attended office. Even if something missed on a Monday, Wednesday, Tuesday, any of these days, next Sunday will be examination, that's the rule. But I have not seen Kerala it happens. Yesterday there was a government college, Kodungallur KKTM College, called me for a program. I said I have 2 days free in this month, 26th January. It doesn't happen in other state, but here it's a holiday. I have nothing else except a few appointments given to somebody who have to come and meet me in Dinigalapura. I can postpone it by telephone. I may either meet in the early morning or evening. I can spare time from 10 to 4 for you. See if you want. They called me, the principal called me for a program. Introduction itself is interesting. So recently we had a NAC visit. They found teachers have not been trained. Therefore we wanted to conduct a program. It's not the teacher's requirement not to improve the quality, but NAC said you should conduct a program. We are conducting for Namke Vasai, for namesake. We have 50 teachers. If 20 of them are coming, we will have it on 26th or 7th. And I deliberately did it, though I have another day to test the teacher. I know this comes like this. So I said, 20 teachers participate, I will not come. If there are 50 of them coming, a day you call, I'm sure it never happens. So they wanted to conduct because NAC says that. It is not because you want somebody to come and improve the quality. Improving quality is not the aim. What's the aim? We do it for namesake. That's a problem which we have. LIC insurance agents come and attend. You ask any of the development officers in any of the districts here, they must have attended my class. They spend money and attend classes because they wanted to do good business. They know when they attend one day program, we train them how to market their products. And that's how we train them. So when we train them, they know that it is useful for them for doing a good business. But I think no teachers believe that, okay, you listen to few classes, we will improve. If at all I have some little knowledge, it is because I have attended Gavarikar's class. I have attended Narlekar's class. I have attended Eshpal's class. I have attended ECG Sudarshan's class. I have been sitting with Kalams. I have been with U.R. Rao. I have been with lot of standards in different. See, when I have been assigned for from the recorded talk of MGK to make his paper was my assignment. So when you speak, I have to record and then write it down. And then those days writing, typing was not in our head. Then you have to give it to a typist, get it back, correct it, listen to that, take the script to him and then find out whether some mistake is there and then correct it and rectify. It is not Monday to, no, not Monday to Friday. We all do this extra time we find in our life. I think one, that's why I made a statement saying that don't tell 10 hours of my mentoring is over, you are 2 minutes late, no more mentoring, no problem. That should change. Otherwise, I don't have to teach Sana from 11 o'clock to 1 o'clock. That was the class which I took. When we have camps, rarely we get time to sleep. Children will come on rotation. Somebody will start doing something. Next person will start disturbing us. It's not disturbance. Maybe sleep is disturbed, but your academic skill or academic thrill is motivating us to do more job. So I'm sure you have got good children. Your aim is to grab them to the interest which you can really inculcate in them and then to make them. You must have the credit of saying, my best children are now, because of my mentoring, they have become like this, like this, like this. Just for WWS, as far as the authorities are concerned, because 3 years is over, third year degree students are coming out to WWS. Sure, this present government will ask a question. Some senior officers will ask a question. Give the list of all WWS students who passed out from the degree. Tell me where did they reach now. Right or wrong? Anybody who evaluates this scheme will have to do this. So from Pioneer College, WWS, 30 students must have been under mentorship of different teachers for last 3 years. Now they will write examination by next year, this August 2017. Where are they? How many of them got into masters in the Central Universities, list them like that, the best is IIT, maybe IISc, Central University, where are they? Don't have to create from Pioneer College or SN College or maybe any of these colleges, everybody need not go. Will you be able to say with the credit saying that under 30 children, 6 of them are into the best institute in India? Then this program becomes successful. In 2 years of my teaching in engineering college, I always boast that one of my students who got admission in 3 IITs for his M.Tech after GATE, best IITs in India. He was in confusion which IIT has to go. He came to me again. I said, don't go to IIT, try for IAS. He asked me, why is it? I said, your interest is in mathematics. So his subject was computer science. Computer science with mathematics, there are a lot of good researchers in IAC. That many are not there in the IIT. So IAC you should take. But his parents said there is an IIT very close to his house itself is in Hyderabad. So parents were insisting him join in this IIT so that anyway you got a gate. IIT is not bad anywhere, whichever IIT is very good. So you can go from home and then come back. Why to shift to Bangalore? I said no, go. And he asked me what are all the reasons which I should write to tell my parents so that I can convince my parents. He wrote down in paper and went. And when parents asked, look, read this. Like that he was bothered. And then anyway, he went for IAC. I've got my children there who are senior students. I gave accommodation to them, took care of them, trained him for how to appear for interview, because senior students will know how to, what are the questions asked. More than me, my children can help them. That's why I use my senior students for getting the junior students. They did all that. He appeared interview. After interview, I was eager to know the result because I am the person who pushed him there. He came out and said, sir, they said no admission for me in NMS. I said, how come, yeah? You are one of the genius person who I have seen and I have great hope on you. Anyway, they must have not been happy with the way you have answered because you are mentally prepared that you don't want to appear IAS because, I mean, in the sort of sense, because your parents forced you not to go, right? So don't worry, it's good. As per your parents' wish, let me join in IIT, come back peacefully. But they asked me to wait. I said, then there is some catch. They have told you that you have no admission for MS and asked you to wait, means what? Sir, am I in waiting list or something? I said, for MS admissions in IAC, there is no waiting list. Because people don't miss joining them, right? This is the last interview, is the last one. Then after some time, 2 hours after that, he telephoned, sir, one good news. They asked me to apply for PhD direct. No MS admission, but what is the admission given? Directly PhD. So my credit sometime, we know that no children are good. Payanur College, I keep always giving one example that KTK, Professor KTK is responsible for making my cousin a PhD in chemistry from Princeton University. He would have joined in a bank, he got a bank job after BSc chemistry. All his two sisters and one brother was working in bank, my cousin brother and cousin sisters. Radhakshan also got a job in bank. He was deciding to go and join. Only KTK, no relatives. Not including my brother who was a professor in college, said don't go. Yeah, job, very good, bank job is very good. Go. KTK said no. You are good in chemistry, go and learn chemistry from IIT Chennai. That was a turning point in his life. So sometime when some options are there, there has to be somebody who strongly will tell you don't. So all of your children, whether you are in mentoring or not, maybe somebody else will be mentoring the senior students, make sure that all of them apply in best universities and best institutes, try for admissions in the best colleges in this world, not in just India. That should be there. For which you will have to do a lot of extra work. I'll tell you, admissions in abroad, you need to have lot of extra certificate other than the marks and the university rank. And those certificates are extra programs which we can do, which you can do or which your children can do from the open school programs or open university programs like Coursera, edX. There are programs under edX and Coursera. So these are the things which you have to tell your children. Unfortunate that none of you have got a paper and pen. You are not writing down, you are just listening like this. As if everything what I said, the Coursera, edX, everything is inside you. I am sure you will go back and say he said something which I don't remember. But it's all useless. Because nothing is taken down. If you don't take it down, you don't keep it with you. I don't know whether SN College has given some paper and pad and pen with you. Nothing is written and given. If you don't have, you should ask somebody. And as teachers, you should have at least a pen and paper with you. That's also not there. I am making note of whatever points comes in my... You don't have to, if you have a smartphone, that is a note for you. Whatever points being told here, I am making note here. So at the end, I have got a note which is to be sent to the OSD saying that these are all the points which came from SN College. These are the points which came from some other college. I keep preparing notes. I am not seeing any of you doing that. I think every student who comes, there are few people who are recording the whole audio. Okay, when you make general statement, it becomes like this. It should be a habit. I am recording the whole thing. Though this is my 10th program of cluster, I am recording all this because I want to know whether I did a mistake, what comments others make, what are the points. If I miss something, I should re-listen to this. And I am not doing in the same style everywhere, because it all depends on your response. The response changes, the activity comes more. If you all become very serious and let me hear what this fellow is going to tell, who is this man who comes and tell me to teach what I should do? That is the attitude, but it is entirely the output becomes different. More activity, that's why I have to beg you many times. Please come forward, ask some suggestions. Though after everything I am giving you suggestion, you didn't ask me a question. Every mentor first should talk to all the mentees. Probably that could be one of the best method. And let them select whom do they want. You have to know how to assign. Mentors are assigned with some mentees, right? Right? Is it your choice? No. Random selection. I think this is like a leaf given to you in a sadhya tree. Everything is dumped there. You are supposed to eat it, right? What is the buffet system? Buffet system is everything is given, you can pick up. So I think the mentee should have an option to select the best mentor. Then what will happen? Some of them will get 20 and the other fellow will be an open shop, no takers. That also can happen. If that happens, it is good. If you are not able to prove that you are good, you are actually getting one student is also becoming the worst. That's the biggest thing. Don't ever do that. So you should be social. You should have the ability to speak, you should have the communication skill, you should have the interpersonal skill, you should have the social skill, mixing with them, taking care of them, all that is essential. If you don't have it, I am sure a good student also will suffer under it. Fine? So open up. Don't